so much that we're hearing in the news and everywhere. But let not our hearts be troubled. We won't be overwhelmed.
Let's declare that over this city.
Hallelujah! Our
God!
January,
morning or evening. And maybe I'll press my way, and maybe I'll write this down, and I've got enough hope to believe. Let's stand with them. We all know what it's like to feel weak. We all know what it's like to seek opportunity. We all know what it's like to go to a brand new year and think, oh, what's the point? But we stand in agreement that this is the year of more, and that God will do exceedingly and abundantly above all they can ask or think. And so sometimes we pray from a place of intimidation. Sometimes we pray from a place of stillness and quietness and almost being subdued, and that's okay. But tonight, we're praying from a place of authority. We're praying from a place that we know who and whose we are. We know that we are King's kids. Turn to them and say, I'm a child of the King. So I'm going to pray like a child of the King. If you want to write your prayer request anytime throughout this night, you can come up and write it. But let's begin to pray now. Stretch your hands towards the prayer wall. Open up your mouth, everyone. No music. Everyone in the house from the front to the back. Let's begin to pray right now. Let's pray. Pray, 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 pray. Open up your mouth. Hallelujah. Pray for peace. Pray for family members, pray for divorced couples, pray for marriages, pray for health, pray for wisdom, pray for guidance, pray for hope, pray for opportunities, new doors, pray for justice, pray for hope, pray for love. Come on, church. Come on, church. Come on, church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Every single prayer request on the wall. Every single prayer request. No prayer is too hard. No prayer is too small. Every prayer. Come on, church, a bit louder, a bit louder, a bit louder. Push a bit more, push a bit more. Woo! Do it, God. Do it, God. Do it, Jesus. Do it, Jesus. We come by faith. We come by faith. Without faith, it's impossible to please you. So we come by faith, and we stand in agreement. And we will be a great testimony of your works. In Jesus' name. I want you to clap your hands like it's already done. Come on, clap your hands like it's already done. Amazing pastor from New Jerusalem Apostolic Church. We've been trying to get Pastor Yvonne Brooks
joke with her because every year I invite her, and she's always busy. She's so busy. But we want to thank God for her being in the house. She's going to lead us in some prayer. All the women, make some noise. Tonight's your night. Be out here for Pastor Yvonne until she comes.
Something better to do. And this is third night or third day of Head Start. Is it three? Four? Well, when did you start?
Sunday.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I thought you started on Monday. Amen. This is the fourth day. So if you were just here for curiosity, tonight you would have stayed at home. Amen. But tonight we've come because we desire more of God. We want something out of the ordinary. I don't want to repeat 2018. I don't want to live a groundhog life. You know that movie where the guy lived the same life every day? But I personally, you have to make your own resolution. I want to go deeper. I want to go higher. I want to fulfill the potential that is on my life. Amen. If I don't do it now, I'm asking myself, when am I going to do it? Because I'm not getting younger. I know I look as if I am. But I'm not getting younger. I'm getting older. And I need it with great haste that I must press into the presence of God and receive what He has for us. I'm so glad to see all the different faces here tonight. This lets me know that this is a collaboration. We're working together. And I discovered that unity is the place where God commands the blessing. So if you want to be positioned for a blessing, you have to be in that place of unity. It means that we say the same thing and we do the same thing and we cooperate with one another. Amen? Amen. So I've been asked to lead prayer for about 20 minutes. Amen. And I'm dealing specifically with prayers directed at women tonight. Amen. I know there are men here. It doesn't mean that you get to sit down and do nothing. Every man here either has a mother, a sister, a daughter, or a wife. So you are going to pray as passionately as the... If you don't have a wife, you can get one. Amen. They tell me that you can find them, and that he that finds one finds a good thing. So don't look regret tonight. You can find a wife. Amen. So all of us have some relation. If we're not a woman, we have a relation with a woman. And if we are women, then we are not looking for equality tonight. And we're not looking for parity. Because the word declares to us that, beloved, now are we the sons of God. So I'm not trying to claim a position. I'm not looking for equal pay. I'm not looking for parity with men or to have whatever the world is looking for. But I'm looking for what God has for me in my life. I'm not looking for what He has in your life. He has created you as a unique individual. He created your purpose before He created you. And then He created you to fulfill that purpose. And it's your life's work here on planet Earth to discover what it is God has called you to do. Amen. So I'm pursuing my purpose in God. Hallelujah. And I want to fulfill. I'm so glad that I'm getting older. Because you know, a lot of people think, oh, I don't want to get old because this. And, but I'm getting older. And what I'm finding is I'm caring less about what people think. I'm caring more about what God has for my life. Woo! And so, I don't really care what anybody thinks tonight. You know, because when I was younger, my life was ruled with fear. I was afraid of everything, okay? I was afraid to. I was afraid not to. I was afraid to try. I was afraid to fail. I was afraid of what people would think, about what people would say. And my whole life was just governed by fear. But thank God for getting older. Amen. Amen. I think I'm about to dye my hair red. Amen. I'm just brave enough to do it. With age comes radicalism. That makes you realize if you don't do it now, when are you going to do it? So many people have already died in 2019. A lot of people who thought they would make it over here have not made it. So you that are alive tonight should be giving God thanks and giving Him praise. Hallelujah. You're not in the mortuary waiting to be buried. You are not in the ground. Amen. But you have life. Praise God. And while we live, the writer says it is in Him that we live and move and do what? Have our being. So I want you to make up in your mind tonight, especially the ladies, to stop caring about what people think about you. The only person I want you to worry about is what does God think? What does God say? The second thing that I want you to do is to stop waiting for confirmation for everything. I think God wants me to bake some apple pies, but I'm not sure. I think I need sister so-and-so to give me confirmation. And then I need confirmation from this other person. And then when I get my third confirmation, then I'll seek some more confirmation just to make sure I don't make a mistake. But ladies, I'm telling you, it's time to step out on the dream that God has given you. It's time to step out. And even if you make a mistake, I have learned more from my mistakes than I learned from not doing anything. Praise God. And the lessons that you learn from your mistake, you never forget them. Amen. So it's okay to make a mistake. God will see with you. And God will still bless your endeavors. Amen. So number one, you're going to stop caring about what people think. Number two, you are going to stop waiting for confirmation after confirmation after confirmation before you step out and do what you've been dreaming about. We only want to do things that God has told us to do. But did you know that sometimes you can have an idea and offer it to God and act on it and He will bless it? I think I'm in the wrong place. I thought you said this was Head Start. I mean, you're already 4 days ahead of me and you're not keeping up with me. Come on. I'm not going to tell you to wrap up warm and avoid getting a cold. I'm going to tell you it's time to get out there. We are in a world that's dying. We're in a world that's drifting away from God. If we keep quiet at this time, remember the challenge to Esther. Her Mordecai has said to her, you can stay in that palace if you like, but could it be that you have come to the kingdom for just such a time as this? Don't you dare keep silent. Don't you dare keep your hand by your side. Don't you dare put your hand behind you and wait for somebody else to do it. God has called you to the kingdom for just such a time as this. Amen. And because I know that God hears and responds to His word, my prayer points tonight are taken from Scripture. Praise God. So our first prayer point is taken from Psalm 69, verse 30 and 31. And it says this, I will praise the name of God with a song and will magnify Him with thanksgiving. This also shall please the Lord, greater than an ox or a bullock that hath horns and hoofs. So we've already sang quite a good few amount of songs. Amen? So now it's time for us to open our mouths and thank God for keeping us throughout the whole of 2018. None of us died in 2018. If you did die, please put your hands up so we can take your life. None of us died in 2018. God provided for us all the way through 2018. Every bill that we had has been paid. Amen. God has shown us favor over our lives. Most of us in here are in our right minds. Notice I said most of us, because some of you are not in your right mind. Amen. I know this because I used to be a mental health nurse. So a few people in here are crazy, but that's okay. Be crazy for God. Amen. So He's kept us, He's protected us, He's provided for us, and now we're going to open our mouths, especially the ladies, and we're going to give Him thanks. The scripture says, I will praise Him and magnify Him with thanksgiving. We magnify Him with thanksgiving when we rehearse to Him all of the things that He has done for us in our lives. So we remember them
more valuable than an ox or a bullock. Why? Because human beings are the only ones with intellect that have cognitive ability that can think and remember and then speak from our remembrance. So amen, we're going to give him more glory than the ox and the bullock, more praise than the trees. Because even the trees, when they're swaying the wind, the scripture says that they're giving thanks and worshiping God. But we have an intellect, we have a mind, we have a vocabulary. So please, we're all going to stand together right now, amen, and we are going to pray. We are going to lift our voices corporately. I want you to forget about the person that's next to you. They need to thank God for themselves. But your job in this prayer is to open your mouth and begin to rehearse the blessings and the goodness of the Lord and thank him for what he's already done. Amen, in the name of Jesus. We're going to say in the name of Jesus three times, and then we're going to pray. Amen. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Now let's pray. Father God, in your precious name, tonight, Lord God, as we come into your house, we come with a heart of thanksgiving. We come with praises. We are so joyful, and we're thankful to you, Father God. Because when we look back over the days of our lives throughout 2018, we see your hand at every turn. We see your hand in every instance. We see your hand in every difficulty. We see how you rescued us, how you delivered us, how you healed us, how you kept us in our right minds, how you provided for us, Lord. So tonight we give thanks unto your name. Your words declare that we are to give thanks. Because you are good and your mercies endure forever. So we thank you for our dreams. We thank you for finances, Lord God, to carry out the plans that you laid upon our hearts. We thank you for our families, our children, our homes, our churches, our local communities. We thank you, Lord God, that you have set us in places where we can make a difference. Where we can bring influence, where lives can be changed, hallelujah, where people are touched and influenced for your kingdom. So Lord, we bless you right now. We give you thanks and we give you praise. Our hearts are grateful to you, Father God, because we know that you did not have to do it, but you did, God. You raised us up, hallelujah. You held us in the palm of your hands. You covered us in the cleft of the rock. You provided a way, even when there seemed to be no way. Father God, we bless your name tonight. We give you all the praise, and we give you all the glory. Lord, we thank you for your matchless favor, for your loving kindness, which is better than life. Tonight, our lips praise you, and thus we bless you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Because your loving kindness is so great toward us. Father, we thank you, Lord. Thank you even for this time of prayer. Thank you, Lord God, that our hearts can remember your goodness. Release your hand tonight, Father, and help us that we will not leave this place like we came. Help us that we will have a new resolve. Help us, Lord God, that we will care more about what you have to say than we care about what anybody else has to say. Hallelujah. We bless your name tonight, and we give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Come on, give him thanks. Give him thanks. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, and his mercy endureth forever. As you give thanks and praises, what is happening is that even the little that you have is increasing right now. Amen. Because everybody loves to be remembered. Everybody loves to be thanked. Amen. So as you release your praises to God, he is working on your behalf. Make no doubt about it. Amen. So it's always good to give thanks. Our next point, amen, is from Lamentations 3, 22-23. And it says, it is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed. Remember, none of us died in 2018. So it's of the Lord's mercies that we're not consumed, because his compassion fails not. They are new every, not once a month, not once every 6 years, not at Christmas, not on your birthday, but every morning. He releases new mercies and new manna into your life. Hallelujah. I found a verse that goes with that very well. Isaiah 24 verse 15. And it says, therefore, because his mercies are new every morning, therefore glorify the Lord in the dawning light. The name of the Lord God of Israel in the coastlands of the sea. So because you are beneficiaries of his mercies, because he does not allow you to be consumed, early in the morning, you are to open your mouth, lift your hands, and worship him. Amen. Everywhere that you are. So right now, ladies, we're going to take the lead. Because I think that women have such a passion for God. We are going to thank him again now for his mercies. Hallelujah. We're thanking him for the newness and the freshness. Because as women, we love new things. New shoes, new coats, new houses. Don't we love that? So let's thank him for some of those things that he's going to be releasing into our lives this year. Amen. Let us pray together in the name of Jesus. Father God, we bless you. Ah, we give you praise. Lord God, we thank you for your mercies that are new every morning. And your faithfulness is so great. Father God, men will let us down. Friends will let us down. Family members let us down. But God, you never fail. And you never change, even with the changing times. So this evening, Father God, as the sun goes down and we go into the night season, we lift our voices and we give you praise, God. We give you glory. We give you honor. Because we know that there is no God like you. There is none beside you. There is none coming after you. You declared over our lives that you will do a new thing. Hallelujah. So we thank you, Father God, for every new thing that you are about to release into our lives. Release the newness in our spirit, God. A newness in our living. Rejuvenate us in every area of our lives. Rejuvenate us in our relationship, God, both with you and with man. Father God, we thank you for all the provision that you've already made for 2019. We thank you that we will lack nothing. We thank you that we will not do without anything that is necessary for life and for godliness. But you have released every favor over our lives. We thank you for those women, God, who need husbands. Father God, we pray for them right now. We call them out from wherever they are. Lord God, we ask that they will present themselves in your house, God, so that the ladies who want to have companionship and be married, that this will be done according to your will. For those who want children, we bless them now, God. We speak to their wombs. We speak life. We speak productivity. We speak fruitfulness in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Father God, that whatever else is needful or necessary, that you're about to release it. God, I don't know about anybody else, but I believe your word tonight. I believe that nothing shall be impossible with you. I believe, God, that even when the doctor said no, you will say yes. And tonight we believe your report. Hallelujah. Father God, we believe your report for healing and deliverance. We believe your report for every financial provision. We thank you for the spirit of creativity. We thank you for new businesses. We thank you for innovation. In the name of Jesus, we thank you that all limitations are broken off of our lives as women. We thank you that there is no such thing as a glass ceiling. But we thank you, God, that in your kingdom, we are your sons and we're your daughters. And you provide for us all that we have need of. Come on, somebody say amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bless your name, God. And we thank you that as we call on upon your name. Oh God, as we petition you, Father God, we thank you that the answers have already been released. Amen. Hallelujah. We thank you because your words declare that as we stand praying, we ought to believe that we receive that which we've asked for, and then we shall have it. Tonight, Father God, we have everything that we have prayed for. God, we might not be able to see it right now, but we thank you, Father God, that it's already done. We receive it in the name of Jesus. God, we receive higher heights. We receive new depths. We receive the spirit of revelation and wisdom in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We thank you that things that are hidden from the wise and prudent are being revealed to the babe and suckling. We thank you, God, for an innovative spirit, even our worship, even our prayer life, even in the way that we live for you, God, so that your glory might be reflected in every area of our lives. Ha! Shonda Rabba! Ah, hallelujah! I would just love it if we could begin to speak in our heavenly language right now and just charge this atmosphere. Let us create a platform tonight on which God will be able to stand to minister to us. Amen. Because you didn't come here tonight because you're okay. You came here tonight because you know that you need something from the Lord. And we have to create that platform on which he will stand. Amen. So begin to charge the atmosphere. Speak in your heavenly language. Let God know. Communicate with him. Hallelujah. Scriptures, amen. Hallelujah. There's Proverbs 31, verse 25 through to 27, and verse 30 through to 31. Hallelujah. I speak this scripture over every woman in this room. I'm just going to do the last two verses. Charm is deceptive. Beauty does not last, but a woman who fears the Lord, she will be greatly praised. Reward her to all she has done. Reward her for all she has done. Let her deeds publicly declare her praise. Amen. Hallelujah. So you can pray that in your own time, because we're supposed to pray without ceasing, not just when we come together like this. Amen. You can please be seated. Amen. I'm gonna stop right here. I'm gonna come down, but I want to leave you with a chorus, amen, just the chorus of a song, because I just believe that one touch from him changes everything. Amen. That's not what I'm going to sing, so don't sound so enthusiastic. Amen. He touched me. Oh, he touched me. And oh,
Be touched.
on your story and where he's brought you from. There would I be if it wasn't for the grace of God. Where would I be if it wasn't for the grace of God? He knows my secrets. He knows my flaws. He knows my obstacles. But he still touched me. If you're grateful, clap your hands and give him a praise. Time is fast spent, and I want to put the woman of God on. Time is fast spent, so I want to. So please be seated so I can behave myself. Let's go. Bless the name of Jesus. Can we praise God for Pastor Yvonne Brooks? Thank you so much for sharing from your heart and for being here today.